Yes, and I respect that. But my client has a championship to contest. So if you want our participation, I'm afraid the concessions are mandatory. Yes, that's fine. Get back to me when you can. Goodbye. No one ever just signs the contract. Anyway, thanks for coming by on such short notice. I just needed to cover a couple of quick things with you before you race. Firstly, as requested, here's a copy of your contract. It's a rolling deal. However, the team reserves right of termination if you fail to meet performance standards. You're second driver for now, but work hard, hit your targets, and I'll be able to sweeten the deal. I'm also looking to get you into some invitational events throughout the season. The experience and exposure from these will be great for your image. Plus, you'll get to drive some nice historic cars. Now then, go get ready for the next session, and good luck.
The track acclimatization program, available in free practice sessions, allows you to learn the track whilst earning resource points for the development of your car. On-track markers show the key points through each corner, and the more of these you're able to consistently drive through at an appropriate speed, the higher your score and the more resource points you'll be rewarded with. Try and chain together multiple successful corners for a consistency boost to your score. Consistency over a long distance is vital in Formula One, so being able to manage tyres and reduce tyre wear is a useful skill. The tyre management program available in free practice sessions will help you learn tyre management while earning resource points for development of your car. Be careful on the controls to reduce the amount of tyre slip and therefore wear. The better you can do this, the higher you will score and the more resource points you'll receive. You'll need to balance tyre management with speed, as you must stay under the target lap time. When the on-screen bar moves towards the red end, that means that you're wearing your tyres more than expected at this part of the lap. When it moves towards the purple, you're wearing them less. Stay in the green or purple for a successful test. The qualifying pace program available in free practice sessions challenges you to beat a target time that corresponds to an expected position on the starting grid. Complete 3 flat-out laps on the fastest tyre compound to set the best time you can, and you'll earn resource points for hitting your target. The drag reduction system, or DRS, opens a flap on the rear wing to reduce drag and improve the straight line speed of the car. Drivers are able to use this system in specific DRS zones as long as the circuit is dry. There are no additional restrictions to DRS use in practice and qualifying. However, in a race, the system can only be used when the driver is 1 second or less behind another. Watch the bar at the bottom of your multifunction display as you approach the DRS zone to see your distance to the activation point, and activate it by pressing the DRS button when the prompt appears. The multifunction display is a vital tool to give drivers control over their cars and make important information visible during a race. It's possible to cycle through the screens on the MFD to access the settings, such as brake bias or the tyres to be fitted at the next pit stop, as well as car condition, component temperatures and race strategy information. When speaking to your engineer through the radio, the MFD is also the place where you'll be able to view and select your available commands. The safety car may be deployed if there's an incident or if the conditions are too dangerous to drive in. Once the safety car is out on track, there's no overtaking permitted and you must keep your lap time above a minimum in order to safely form a queue behind it. You can judge your pace using the delta element of the on-screen display. Ensure you drive slowly enough to keep it positive. Once the line has formed, the safety car will re-enter the pits. Remember that there's no overtaking until the green flags at the first safety car line. If the incident is less severe, the virtual safety car may be deployed. It's not necessary to form a queue under the VSC, but just stay above a certain delta time and obey yellow flag rules until the virtual safety car period comes to an end. There's a huge amount of time to be won and lost in the pits, but ensure that you don't get too greedy as you approach the pit lane speed limit line. On the approach, you'll see a notification of the pit lane speed limit and your distance to the limit line. If you cross this threshold too fast, you'll be given a speeding penalty, so be careful. There are valuable tenths to be won by getting it right though, so leave your braking as late as you dare. At the pit exit, it's important not to cross onto the racetrack before reaching the end of the white pit exit line. Tyre selection is a critical issue in Formula 1, and the current tyre regulations give individual drivers more freedom than ever. Pirelli allow 13 sets of dry tyres and 7 sets of wet tyres for a full race weekend, so you need to be careful to make your allocation last the distance. From the dry sets, 3 are pre-selected by Pirelli and marked as mandatory for Q3 in the race, but drivers can adjust their allocation for the other 10 sets from the 3 available compounds. Just remember, during the Grand Prix, every driver must use one of Pirelli's mandatory tyres plus 1 set from a different compound. The formation lap is an opportunity to practice your race start and put some energy through your tyres and brakes to get them up to the optimal temperature for the beginning of the race. When the light goes green, pull away from the grid and stay in position, making sure to keep your car in good condition as you drive a lap at a steady but consistent pace in order to prepare for the start of the Grand Prix. Races aren't won from the start line, but they can be lost, so getting a good start can make an important difference to your Grand Prix. As the lights come on, engage the clutch by holding the gear up button. Then, feed in the throttle to build up the revs. When the lights go out, release the clutch and it's away we go. But be careful not to release the clutch too early or you may end up jumping the start. If your RPM is too low when you drop the clutch, your car may go into anti-stall. Don't panic if this happens, keep a cool head, clutch in, build up the RPM and then release the clutch, just like the start procedure, to get underway again. In the unforgiving world of Formula 1, free practice sessions are a vital part of any Grand Prix weekend. During your F1 career, you'll be able to utilise these sessions to complete practice programmes which will help you learn the track and earn you points that can be invested in developing your car. You'll also be able to adjust your car setup over the course of these sessions to try and find those extra fractions of a second. In today's era of hybrid engine technology, Formula 1 employs a strict maximum limit on the fuel load. In order to run as light as possible, teams will tend to underfuel their cars, but this means drivers need to save fuel during the race. Fuel saving can be achieved through certain engine settings or by using a technique called lift and coast. This technique involves lifting off the throttle a few meters before the normal braking zone and allowing the drag from the air to begin the process of slowing the car. This reduces the amount of fuel used while keeping the speed relatively high. The best place to employ lift and coast is at the end of a long straight into a heavy braking zone. The race strategy program is all about developing a personal race strategy. This test will help the team to understand how much fuel is required and also the best tyre policy to employ for the race. The results are determined from data which is directly affected by your driving style, so managing your fuel and tyre wear during the test, for example, will result in a strategy that caters to these qualities. Keeping up with the development race is vital for continued success in Formula One, but resources are limited, so choose carefully where you allocate them. Throughout your career, you will earn resource points, and there are four departments of car development in which you can spend them: chassis, aerodynamics, powertrain, and durability. At any one time, each of these can be tasked with researching a new part and, in some cases, improving their infrastructure. Higher levels of upgrade will cost more and take longer to complete, but the performance gains will be significant. You'll need to find the right balance to suit your needs and maximise performance throughout the season. Over the course of the Formula One season, each driver is limited to a total of 4 power units and 4 gearboxes, with penalties issued for going over that limit. Each component wears with use, which causes performance degradation over time. Drivers will have to monitor the wear levels of each relevant component and choose when to swap them out for fresh units in order to find the best balance between performance and reliability.
We're about to join the action in what is sure to be an interesting practice session here in Melbourne. It's not long until we get the session underway and we'll have some cars appearing out on the track. Anthony Davidson is here as usual to help take us through the action. And Ants, I've seen some questions on social media and other places about this current crop of F1 cars and why they're so much faster now, despite being significantly heavier than the previous generations of machines. Take us through that one.
I'd be happy to, Crofty. And simply put, it's a matter of grip. Now, that comes from two sources. You have what we call mechanical grip, which comes from the surface of the tyre sticking to the road. And these tyres are significantly wider now when compared to previous years, so they have the potential for more mechanical grip. Then you have the downforce, of course, which pushes the car into the road as the air moves over it, thus generating grip. And these cars have about 20% more downforce, which is more than enough to overcome the added weight.
you get a chance, make sure to run some of our practice programs. They don't all need to be done in one session, but there's valuable data there to help race strategy and car development. Don't push the car just yet. The track is still green. Try and take it easy for the first couple of laps.
Welcome to Melbourne, where the practice session is about to start for this weekend's Australian Grand Prix. The pre-race talking is over. Now it's time for the drivers to show their worth. Welcome then to all our viewers and of course to Anthony Davidson as well. Now, Ant, I wanted to ask you, obviously there's a lot of hard work involved in these sessions, a lot of simulations as well. Is this something the drivers enjoy, or is it just a routine that becomes a chore?
Well, there's nothing routine about driving a Formula One car, I can tell you that. 300 kilometres per hour down the straights, 4G through the corners. It's hard to ignore those forces acting on your body. It's lap after lap of hard, exhausting work. You always enjoy driving these cars, it's a real privilege. Although I must say, if you're having a day where you can't get the car to do what you want and it's generally underperforming, then it's a lot harder to stay motivated. But never a chore, no. Even if you're having a tough start to the weekend, at this point you know that if you work hard at it, there's still an opportunity to turn things around.
Thank you.
Have set us back a little. We should probably do before qualifying is the qualifying program. Let's prepare ourselves as best we can. We don't want to find ourselves starting at the back. Our best lap so far is a 1:42.7. All set. Everyone clear? Car to track. Repairing the damage to the car. Our best lap so far is a 1:42.7. Done a race simulation on any tyre yet. We have multiple sessions available, so it isn't urgent right now, but we should make time for a tyre wear program at some point. To keep an eye on your tyre usage. We have to give two sets back at the end of this session, so they'll be unavailable for the rest of the weekend. We'll hand over the two most worn sets, so don't ruin tyres you might want to use later. best lap so far is a 1:42.7. We're 20th in the speed trap, 129.0 miles per hour.
Turn 14. only by Senna at 65 pole, Schumacher at 68. This season marks the
Our repairs have set us back a little. So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 42.7. We're 20th in the speed trap, 174.9 miles per hour. Right, I'll get these changes made. All complete. Mechanics, please stand clear. We're ready to go.
Going into the 2017 season, Lewis Hamilton held 63 pole positions, bested only by Senna at 65 poles and Schumacher at 68.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:35.9. Let's update the setup. Everyone ready? Okay, let's go.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Hamilton, Raikkonen and Sebastian Vettel. Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F1 action soon.
Thank you. got my message. Perfect. Welcome to home away from home. We get more real-time data from the factory now than ever before, and it all comes through here. So I have to spend more time checking over the reports and less time hunting you down in the hospitality suite. To that end, we... Sorry, just a sec. Yeah, Chris here, is this important? I'm in the middle of something. Okay. Right. Well, that makes no sense. Have Sarah reset the simulation and run it again. Okay. Sorry about that. As I was saying, we've set up a desk for you at the front here. You can get onto the network from your laptop, so make sure to check the R&D screen regularly. And let us know how you want to use the data that we've collected over the weekend and through the practice programs. Also, bear in mind that the news from the factory won't always be good. Sometimes tests fail, like you've seen just now. And when that happens, we have to divert additional resources to fix it. C'est la vie, I'm afraid.